A very good morning to one and all. I, Dr. Renuka Roy from SK Porwal College, Kamthi, welcome all my dear student friends and the faculty members of BSc Supplementary English from all the affiliated college and the collaborating colleges to this second day of online lecture series, BSc Semester 2 Supplementary English. For today's session, we have with us Dr. Vinita Virgandham. Madam is a very diligent academician and a scholar. Dr. Virgandham has master's degree in three subjects, wise, English, linguistics, and education. Madam has also received postgraduate diploma in English language teaching from IFLU University, Hyderabad. Madam has done PhD on Taslima Nasreen's works. Madam has many honors and awards to her credit. She is a soft skills trainer and personality developer. Madam works in many government bodies in terms of professional writing. She has attended many workshops and symposiums and conferences and successfully presented papers in many esteemed conferences and workshops. Madam is active in university works also. She is member of many professional bodies and associations. We are very happy to have Madam Virgandham today. She is excellent and she has been awarded for her excellent module development of communicative English. And today's class will be highly rewarding for our students. I now hand over the proceeding to Dr. Virgandham, and I request all the students to get benefited from her presentation.
Virgandham. Thank you, Renuka Madam. Thank you so much. And please allow me to share my screen. I'm sharing my screen. Okay, is the screen clearly visible?
Yes, madam.
Renuka madam, and thank you, Amit sir, for motivating me here. And a very warm good morning to all my students, to all the affiliated college fellow colleagues of mine, and my dear students who are there on YouTube as well as on Zoom platform. It's a proud privilege, you know, to be invited on such a platform and to be sharing a few things that I have known throughout my career, and given opportunity and the trust that has been shown by BOS Languages of Science and all the members of Board of Studies of Languages, BAC, and all my fellow colleagues from all the collaborating colleges here today. Please accept my heartfelt gratitude for providing me a platform. And having said that, and let me now introduce you to one of the most beautiful short story of Kartar Singh Duggal. And this short story, you know, it's a post-partition story which has been, which expresses lot of the society's undercurrent. Okay, now to just let me introduce you all to the author of this short story, Dr. Kartar Singh Duggal. He has been a wonderful writer and has immensely contributed to the genre of short stories in Punjabi literature. And let me also for let you all know, it's a vast, vast genre of Punjabi literature which hasn't been explored. And a lot many stories, short stories by K.S. Duggal and other writers also needs to be explored. You know, it's a genre which hasn't been touched upon for a long, long time. And when I was like going through the short story of K.S. Duggal, other than the taxi driver, it's really rich in its content. Okay, so it's the short story, The Taxi Driver. It talks about the refugee, poverty, and so many aspects connected to it. You know, when I talk about the taxi driver, let me also give you a little bit of information. You know, there was Nam Ketan's movie made the taxi driver, which had Devanand as a lead hero. But this taxi driver, the story that we are going to look into today, and the movie, the taxi driver, both are different. There's no connection between the two. Okay, let me make it very clear. And if you all remember, there was a song which was very famous, Taxi Driver, the movie Taxi Driver song, Jai to Jai Kaha. So, you know, something related to the Taxi Driver, the movie, which was very romantic and very good story there. But this, the story that we are dealing today is different from the movie that we have seen, which was in the era where we had black and white movies. Now, just to give a glimpse to our students who have not seen the black and yellow colored taxis, I just have a clipping of a taxi. They can immediately relate to what a taxi would be. And they had this meter on it, which was written taxi, and they used to turn it around so that the meter would be on. So this is for all of our students who now ride in Uber and Ola and other available rented conveyances. So this is a beautiful picture of the taxi, which now hardly we find some of them in Mumbai now. But then this was a way of, you know, commuting from one place to another. Okay. So this is the Taxi Driver, the movie, which is now Ketan's Taxi Driver, just for you all to have a glimpse of, like, you know, when we read something, we just love to relate things. Okay, so that is just for an engaging class. I just had taken up this clip for you all. And now coming back to the story. Now, this is a story in which we have three characters. Jittu, whose another name is Hardeep Singh. You know, he is a refugee in India. And he was earlier, before the partition of India and Pakistan, he belonged to the other part. Okay. And after partition, he had to come back to this side of the border. And see, now there is something which is, like, you know, very sentimental things, and the aspect of, you know, the personality of Hardeep Singh, who was, when in Pakistan, the other side of the border, he was Hardeep Singh. When he comes to this side of the border, he's known as Jittu. His another name is Jittu. Okay. And we have the character, his wife named as Bunty, and their son Gullu. Okay. These are the three characters. And one thing, you know, we can't say he's a protagonist or he's a hero or he's a heroine of this short story. But then this story is itself very engaging in terms of how the society worked then, under what circumstances had these people to earn, to make a living out of driving a taxi. Okay. Now, let us understand the story. We have a story wherein it's the hero, the protagonist, wherein we say the lead person in this story is Hardeep Singh, alias Jittu. And he tells us the present, what is happening. And then immediately in the middle of the story, he goes back. There's a flashback wherein he tells us about what had happened then. And again, he comes back to the present scenario. So there are three parts which we can divide this short story, just for us understanding. Okay, just for our understanding of the story. Now we come across a word called Kholi. Now, you know, people who are in Mumbai, they might be knowing what a Kholi means. And, you know, in a very sophisticated manner, if I talk about a Kholi, we can call it, like, you know, a studio apartment wherein we have everything, like, you know, it's a bedroom, it's a living room, you have a kitchen in it there itself, you have everything. But my mind you all, a Kholi is not a studio apartment. It's just a room, a dingy room, which is dark And see the story. It's all about the conditions prevalent then. And this is the image here. It's just a symbolic image of how a Kholi can look like. But I don't think then we had these many flows for a Kholi. Okay. This is just for the understanding of what a Kholi means. A Kholi means a one room wherein you have a kitchen, you have washing area, you can do your laundry, you can wash your utensils, and you have to sleep there itself. So either, even if there are 5 or 6 or 7 members, they have to adjust in the same little room. That is called Kholi. Now, with the permission of the chair and the organizers, I would be using a bit of, you know, I'll go bilingual. I'll use some Marathi or Hindi, wherein I want my students to understand what it actually means, because there are a lot many words which are in Hindi. Okay, so this being a translated version, many of the words they couldn't be, you know, translated into English, like a Kholi. Okay, you I hope you understand what I'm trying to explain you. So now next is now the present, and see how the story begins. A wonderful thing that I found in this story is he is so simple at heart. Dittu or Hardeep Singh, he's so simple at heart. He keeps on saying, he see how it is, how people are. And who is he explaining about? He's telling us about the rich. And the sentence with an exclamatory mark starts, these damned rich. The first sentence of the story, these damned rich. So now, why such a word for rich people? What made him say? And you know, that to his contemptuously, like, you know, he had this, that anger in him, which makes him say damned rich people. So this rich people are always damned. Okay. Why are they damned? Why does he want to use this word? These people are so careless, and he's full of, you know, a kind of hatred. Not exactly hatred is what I'm going to use here, but there is something anger in him against the rich people. And why? We'll just move ahead as the story progresses. We'll come to know what happened and why does Dittu say this. Now see, as he parked his taxi opposite his Kholi. Now this Kholi word, I already have shown you the image of a Kholi. He notices a wallet, you know, bulging with currency notes at the back seat, in the back seat of his taxi. And it's very much evident that there might be some passenger who forgot his purse. Now, you know, this particular statement of Dittu, when K.S. Dugal writes, and in between, he gives us conversation between Bunty and Dittu, conversation between the passengers and Dittu. I know he's frightened. Dittu is frightened at the mere look of the wallet, which was bulging with currency. And what makes him so fearful? No, and he doesn't know what to do with that wallet. You know, because as the story progresses, we'll come to know what makes him so fearful. At the mere looking of the wallet, he feels, oh my God, not again. It was a windfall. It's not again. There might be something which had happened earlier. And now he says, not again, again, a wallet in my taxi. And he's been plying his taxi, you know, through the length and breadth of the city the whole day. See, a taxi is hired by so many people. So who has forgotten the wallet? It's not known to him. So he had picked his last passenger by the roadside and dropped him at the railway station. But now where could he find the owner of the purse, the wallet, which had so much of money in it? Now, and you know, there is another aspect to Dittu's thinking, for Dittu's fear at the mere looking of this wallet. What he feels is money or things found like this, which have been lost property, like, you know, lost property. If you find anything lost by somebody, he feels it's always cursed. And let me use a Hindi word for the word cursed here. Shrapit ya shapit. That is what I would like my students to understand. Okay, it's cursed. Okay, it always has a curse on it. So what he feels is if he uses that money, it will not be beneficial. It will harm him in any other way. Okay, so now he had already suffered once. And now here we come to know when the story begins that he had already suffered once by using that particular thing. And what had happened? a lady had forgotten an attache case. Now, your attache is a Hindi word, attache case. It's if I have to give you an English word for this, it can be call it a suitcase, wherein you put in all your clothes, or it's called a travel bag sort of thing, attache case, in his taxi. And you know, they had they could hardly think about it. See, now he is damned rich people. He using the first statement there with an exclamation. And again, as the story progresses, he has to always have something or the other to say about the rich people. They hardly have their wits. That means these people, they're careless. They don't use their brains. And that is why, that's the reason they forget things. These moneyed people. Your moneyed means the rich people. Okay. And every article in the attache case was like a plague. You know what is a plague? It's infectious. It's contagious rather. Okay. And what happens? His wife uses this particular clothes which were in the attache case. When a passenger forgot it, they couldn't return it back, though he intended to return. He couldn't do that because he didn't know where he could find that person who forgot the attache case. Okay. And what happened? Now, did two things. Hardeep Singh thinks that because his wife had used the clothes, the sari and the blouse, which was in that attache case, that she contracted leukoderma. Okay. Now, what is leukoderma? We'll see in the next slide. And this is an incurable malady. Malady is it's a disease which cannot be cured by anything. Okay. Now see, this is leuko means white, derma means patches, and vitiligo. This is a disease which in wherein you have white patches or blotches all over your face and your hands and everywhere. But see, now here here at this particular point in the story, we find there is superstitious belief also. Okay, as we proceed, you'll come to know each and everything. If you use somebody's sari and blouse, can you get a malady which cannot be cured at all? But ditto things that this is cursed one, because lost property, if you use somebody's lost property, it comes with a curse. And that is the reason his wife has acquired this disease. Bunty has contracted this leukoderma. Okay, I hope until then this is all okay, fine with you all. Let us move on to the next one. Now, what happened? After that, you know, after his wife has contracted leukoderma, that after a long time, whosoever engaged his taxi, now Ditu wanted their address from them. And why did Ditu want the address? He wanted it because if in case they forgot their belongings, he would return it to them. But you know, people thought that Sikh taxi driver was crazy. He was crazy. Why? See, nobody would like to give their address. Why? See, it's something which is related to personal security maybe. Or then they said the Sikh taxi driver was crazy. And Ditu explained to them why he wants. Ditu is tired of explaining them and convincing them why he wanted their address. You rich folk are most careless. Now see, from the first line, as we proceed further and further into the story, you find he's always accusing the rich people with something or the other. He says, you rich folk are most careless, unquote. You sometimes leave something behind the taxi and then it becomes a problem for the poor taxi driver. He can neither return it nor retain it. See his honesty. Earlier we saw superstitious belief. Now see the honesty of Ditu, the values he upholds, the belief that he upholds, that he is really interested in returning the things that they forgot, the passengers forget in his taxi. He wants to return it to them. That is his intention. So sincere, so honest here. Okay, and he convinces them, this is the reason I want to. But the passengers, they say he is a crazy fellow and we don't want to part with the address, or we don't want to tell him our address. Why should we? Now that's the thing. And he says, if I find something in my taxi left by the passengers, I can't return it because I have no address and neither I can retain it. Why I can't retain it? Retain here means I can't keep it for myself, because he feels the things that are left by the passengers, they come with a curse. That means shapit hote hain. Anything which you find comes with a curse. And if you use it, you can contract anything. So that is what it is in his mind has been oriented that way. Okay, so now we go on to the further slide and we'll see what happens next. Now, and Ditu, after this, when people started calling him crazy, means pagal. Okay, when they started calling him the sick taxi driver is crazy, he's asking for addresses. So he said, okay, now I am not going to ask anybody. Okay, because whenever he asked, they used to argue with him and they never gave him the name and address. So he stopped doing it. But what happened? See, try to understand one thing. Whenever he saw the ugly blotches on his wife's face, you know, the face is all, something is because she contracted leukodoma, and it's not because she wore a sari or a blouse of one of the passengers who left the Attachi. Not because of that, because of some other reason that she had contracted this leukodoma. It's something internal, the skin disease that we can call it. Okay, he told himself, whenever he looked at his wife's face, which was like ugly, why? Because she had all white and black patches all over her face and her body. He tells himself, I shall never have anything to do with what doesn't belong to me. Means I don't want which I haven't earned for myself. Now again, see the honesty and the sincerity. Once he wanted to return it to the passengers, the property or whatever wallet or whatever they used to leave it in his, they forgot in his taxi. He just wanted to return it back. Why? Because whenever he looks at his wife's face, he feels it's a cursed thing. The money, the things that they forget, and if I use them, it comes with a curse. With someone's, now it's again he's coming. Now see, the past is over. Now he's again coming into the present and he has a wallet in his hand. And why he has a wallet in his hand? Because his elder son, his son would come to clean the taxi next morning. And if he found the wallet, he'll go and give it to his wife. Okay. Now, so that is the reason he's holding the wallet in his hand and he's thinking, what do I do with it? How do I dispose it off? Because I personally don't want to use it. And I because it comes with a curse, and what do I do? And at this juncture, now the story, you know, Dugal, K.S. Dugal, the writer of this short story, takes us again into the flashback. And Ditu remembered an incident when he takes back, he is into the, now we go into the flashback. Okay, that incident which had taken place several years ago in the main bazaar of the hometown back in Pakistan. Now, he is in India. He is right standing in front of his coli with a taxi. And when he looks back, he finds a wallet. He is holding a wallet. And at that particular time, he is reminded of something that had happened long ago when he was in Pakistan. So let us go into the flashback. Let us find what happened in the flashback now. And then we have this connectivity. So I'm going to go for another slide. Now, this is a bigger one, which is a lot of, the slide has a lot of material content on it. But let me just summarize it for you. He was not Ditu, the refugee. Now, back in India, now see, what do you mean by a refugee? A person who has to leave his native place because of natural calamities, because of war, or because of any other reason whatsoever. And he finds refuge, he finds that security in some other place. And that is the meaning of refugee. He is a refugee in India now because he left Pakistan and he came. And why did he leave Pakistan? Because after the partition, after the independence, you know, after the Britishers left India, India and Pakistan, which was one particular time, it was divided. Okay. And therefore, he being a Hindu or a Punjabi, maybe, he had to return to India because it was left to the people. Those who want to come back to India, they could come back. Those who didn't want to, they could stay back in Pakistan. So this person with his family might be, he returned to, and therefore he is called the refugee. He says, I'm a refugee here. Okay. He was Hardeep Singh. Now he says he was a son of a well-to-do family. Now see the story. He was there in Pakistan. He was from a well-to-do family. His parents were well-to-do. He had good, amount of money to spend on himself. He was not as poor as he is in India right now, because to eke out a living, he is driving a taxi now. Okay, after he had finished his matriculation, now you know we at that particular time the education system was different. They used to call it the 10th class that we have now. They used to call it at matriculation. Okay, and what happens with this boy Hardeep Singh then in Pakistan? See, one evening when he's walking through the bazaar, he's cycling through the bazaar. He finds a packet which was sealed, which is heavy. And you know what he says? He looks around because he's very young at that time. He had just completed matriculation, a teenager supposedly. Okay, he finds a packet which is properly sealed, and he looks around and he sees no one is bothered at that packet. And with that, and the shopkeepers in the bazaar. Bazaar is a heavily crowded with people, and the shopkeepers doing their own business day in and day out. So what he thinks is maybe it's nobody is bothered about it, so let me pick it up. He picks up the packet and he pedals his cycle as fast as he could, and he rides out of the bazaar, and in an isolated place he opens the pack. He keeps on opening layer after layer, and he sees only papers, and still with an intent of finding something in that packet, he tries to open, and you know he has packing paper till the last bit that he took out. And then he realizes, he thinks somebody had played a trick on him. And he feels so bad about himself, so much of guilt. Okay. Now he feels the shopkeepers wanted to test the honesty of the customers. And that's the reason they kept a packet over in the middle of the road. And that he, you know, this makes him, he feels he has blackened his face. Now, what is the meaning of blackened his face? This is a translated short story. Muh kala kar diya. You know, if in Hindi, if you have this word, that means there's guilt, there is shame, and shame on himself. He thinks, why the hell did I pick up this packet? And in the when he goes into the flashback, he tells us he was from a well-to-do family. Okay, now see the connectivity. Okay, he has, and you know, he felt like a spooky hen. You know what's a spooky hen? A spooky hen is, you know, which is fearful, which is you know, which is frightened. And he feels as a spooky hen, and it's like, you know, a spooky hen, you know, it's always clutching. The voice, it's make like croc 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 kukuruku, something, a sound like that. And he feels himself to be a spooky hen, a hen which is very frightened, which is running helter skelter here and there to save itself. And he finds himself to be in that. And at that particular point, when he feels he's blackened his face with the guilt that he picked up a packet which didn't belong to him, which was somebody else's, his entire personality starts to disintegrate. Why the hell did I do that? And that guilt feeling is still in him. Okay, so we move on to the next. So if you want to see a spooky hen, it's like frightened hen. It's like crowing all the time. Okay, it's clucking all the time. And that is how he felt, because he's always reminded of it. Why did I pick up that parcel, that the package, when it didn't belong to me? Why did I do that? So that is how it feels. Okay, now he again comes back to it. Okay, I'll take up the slide after this slide, and let us continue with it. Now what happens? Now he comes back from that flashback, and he gets into his house, his koli, okay? And his wife sees a wallet bulging with currency notes, and she says, oh my God. I know, now she feels, because she has all the, creditors whom she had to pay, they all are knocking at the door day in and day out. They want their money back. And she wants to pay the money back with the help of the currency that was in the wallet which she had. And, you know, Jitu always, what he did was, whatever he earned throughout the day, he would empty his pockets to his wife, and she used to sit counting the coins and the notes separately. And that is how their family used to run by Bunty. Okay. Now, when Bunty wants this money to pay off her debts and to get a good meal, good groceries for her home, for her health, for her children to study in a good school by paying fees, and she wants to save some money for the dowry of a girl. Now, Now, let us try to understand here why she is doing this. Now, there was a system wherein when girls get married, they had to pay dowry. Dowry means the money given by a bride's family to the groom's family. And why does she do this? She tells, my neighbor said she had a baby girl and she started saving money the day the baby girl was born. So even I want to save money because my girl is also growing up. I want to save money for her marriage. Now, see, this was the society then. Okay. We do have exceptions now also. This is the society because we are reading the story in that particular context. Let us try to understand. Yes, dowry system was prevalent then. The Bunty, we should have nothing to do with other people's money. Dittu said to his wife. Now, what happened? Dittu, even now, though he is under a lot of debt, he doesn't want to use that currency which the passenger forgot in his taxi. Even now, he doesn't want to use it. And he keeps on telling Bunty. Bunty is his wife. He tells, no, we don't want to use other people's money. We'll give it to somebody. We'll give it to the Pandit. We'll put it in the temple's alms box. But we won't use it. There was agony on his face. There was that anger. He knew his wife. Why that anger? He knew his wife wouldn't listen to him. And she never listened to him in such matters. And when the money is concerned, when it's all about the well-being of the family, and see, it's even Dittu is concerned of the well-being of the family, no doubt about it. But he doesn't want to use the money left or the money, the forgotten currency, the forgotten wallet, the forgotten things by passengers in his taxi. He doesn't want to use. He only wants to use the money that he has earned, not the money that other people have forgotten and lost. He doesn't want to use the lost money. Who said I'm going to have anything to do with it? I'll pass it on. Who keep on pestering me, says Bunty casually. Now, she says, I will pass it on. See, now what's happening between the husband and wife? It's only the wallet, the forgotten wallet. Bunty wants to use it. Dittu doesn't want to use it. And this is a bone of contention between the husband and wife. And what happens? She says, no, I'm going to use this money. I'm not going to give it to the Pandit. I'm not going to put it in the alms box at the temple. Why? Because they are also going to use it anyway. They are not people who are very honest the way you think they are. They are not like that. They're also going to use it for their own benefits. So why to give it to them? Why shouldn't I use it? This is a question which she puts to Dittu. And Dittu has nothing to say. And he says, she is an impossible woman. Dittu muttered to himself. He says, she is an impossible woman because she doesn't listen to Dittu in such instances and she wants to use the money. Okay, now we're going to the next. Now, again, there is the conversation between Dittu and Bunty continues throughout the story. She wants the money and Dittu is trying to convince her it is not our hard-earned money, so we are not going to use it. But Bunty has nothing to do with its hard-earned money or the lost money that they have found. She just wants to use them for their sake. And here, you know, K.S. Duggal has delicately, intricately woven the conversation between the two of them. There is honesty. And even here, it's honesty. You can't, put Bunty in a compartment and say, she's wrong. But then who is compromising with the values? Or has the situation made them to compromise with the values? It is a question which it needs to be analyzed, and which needs to be thought about. We need to put in a lot of effort to think, is the situation demanding or has Dittu compromised with his values? He tries his best, but what happens? Let's see further what happens as we proceed. And again, he says to Bunty, again, he asks Bunty, I ask you not to have anything to do with the money that doesn't belong to us again. And now, she's asking, in fact, she's revolting. She's in a mode of revolt. It's not a revolt, I would say. She's just answering him back. If I do, she says, yeah, we're not doing anything with this money. Okay, fine, you better understand this. This is what D2 says. But Bunty says, what if I do? What do you do? What will you do if I use this money for our benefit? And he says, I'll skin you alive. Now see, these are the translated stories from Punjabi, and you can't get the exact essence of it. So in Hindi, I have to explain it to you. This means, main tumhari chamdi udher dunga. So this is, I'll skin you alive, right? See the anger. Ditto doesn't want to use the currency that he has found. It's evident throughout. His intentions are very clear. His honesty, his sincerity is so well portrayed here. Okay, but Bunty is a woman who has to run a household. Poor thing, okay? She needs money. And how situations have made them deal with each other. He had never been so rude to his wife. He keeps on telling himself, I haven't behaved so rudely. And why he's behaving now? Because she's hell-bent on spending the money for their benefit. She wants to pay off the debts. Because the people who have lended her money, they are always coming to home. They're creating a ruckus outside asking for money. And with this money, she wants to clear off her debts with the remaining money because the purse was bulging with currency notes. And you know what happens after this conversation? She's not budging. She wants to use the money and she holds her wallet. She snatches the wallet and she holds it to her heart. And she never parts with it. Because she knows if the moment she'll keep it anyway, Ditto will take that wallet and he'll pass it on to the poor people, or he'll put it in the alms box. Whatever is feasible, he'll do that particular thing. And what happens, fearing that he might lose his temper again, and Ditto feels, I might lose my temper, what he does, he comes home and the wife snatches the wallet. He tells her, we're not going to use it, but still she doesn't listen to him. And he doesn't want to get more angry on her, and he gets into the bed and he is off to sleep. Okay, now, after this, what happens, you know, He had gone into bed and he sleeps, and there in his dreams, again, you know, a slight flashback, again, a little bit of, you know, he's taking us into his dreams, and he dreams of what? He dreams that he's driving his taxi, and on the road, he finds a policeman, and the policeman asks to stop him, and he's chalaned by the policeman. You know, he's chalaned, but that means because of, he was on the right track. He was on the right side of the road, but even then the policeman says, I want some money from you. Okay. Now he says, he is a poor taxi driver who hadn't got any passengers from the morning. And this is happening in his dream, mind you all. Okay. This is his dream that he's dreaming. Okay. And he says, please forgive me. And the moment, you know, he begs the policeman to forgive him and to let him go, the policeman doesn't, you know, do that. He doesn't budge. He says, I want, he doesn't listen to Ditto. And when Ditto, you know, he falls on his feet, on the policeman's feet, and he says, please let me go. And the policeman just, you know, kicks him in the stomach. Okay. This is a part of a dream. And then again, what happens? He is dreaming, and in his dream, what happens? He comes, he, you know, starts for the day with his taxi, and he's at the taxi stand. There are so many passengers, but no one comes to Ditto to hire his taxi. So after waiting and waiting for a long time, he just takes out, he moves on his taxi towards the road. And as he's moving towards the road, there's a huge truck, and the truck, and he dashes with his taxi, and there is a huge big accident. And as soon as this accident happens, it's a mangled heap of the taxi. Okay, now this bad dream wakes him up. This bad dream wakes him up, and he's out of his dream. And what he sees, what you know, he wakes up from his sleep, and he's sweating a lot. He's profusely perspiring. And Bunty, you know, Bunty, his wife, she was fallen asleep. She had been sleeping. And where was the wallet? She had held it to her heart like this. Because if she leaves it somewhere, Ditto might take it. And she clutches so tightly see the situation here. See the kind of poverty that they are going through. But still, Ditu is as honest as he could be. But Bunty wants, he said, we are not doing anything wrong. Nothing wrong. If I use the money from the wallet, which a passenger has forgot. And because, now what Bunty tells Ditu is, because the rich people haven't earned this, it's not their hard-earned money. That's the reason they have forgot. If it's the hard-earned money, we would have been more careful. That's what she tells him. Okay. Now, Ditu tried. No, Ditu wakes up and he sees Bunty sleeping and the wallet, she's held it very tightly to her heart. And he tries to snatch that wallet, which is full of currency notes. And, you know, she suddenly wakes up. And see what happens between the husband and wife. And she's holding it very tightly. And Ditu, the husband, is trying to snatch it. And she is like holding it. There's a struggle. There's a kind of a fight to snatch the wallet from Bunty. And, you know, Ditu lost his patience. And, you know, when she's not parting with that wallet, she held it so tightly that Ditu was unable to pull it out from her hands. He lost his patience because he didn't want to use that money. And, you know, he smacked Bunty on her face. Now, this is again, so what happens? And Bunty gave a loud shriek and she shouted so loudly because Ditu had hit her on her face, physical abuse. And which he never rudely talked to his wife. And just because of the money that he didn't want it to use and the lady of the house wanted to use that money, because he lost his patience, he was so angry, Ditu gave her another blow. He wanted the money. She wasn't ready to part with it. And he smacked her on her face. Okay. And Ditu, she gave a loud shriek. She shouted so loudly that he gave another blow. Okay. And the story tells us, you know, such scuffles, such things, the fights, the domestic violence between the quarters, the kholis where Ditu, people like Ditu live, it was usual. So simple, right? The society then had such skirmishes in the house, which were very normal kind of a thing. Nobody bothered about if a husband and wife were fighting or if they had a physical, fight between them, if they abused each other. It was a normal kind of thing for them. The only one thing that makes us think here is the conditions in which they survived. I would use the word survived, not lived here. They survived in such conditions. Okay, taxi drivers were used to such scenes. It is a habitual thing for them. While none of the neighbors bothered about it, their son Gullu woke up. Now, with all these, abuses and loud shriek given by Bunty, made that little boy, his name was Gullu, he woke up and he goes to his mother. And the mother, what Bunty was doing, she couldn't retaliate. So what she does is she abuses, filthy abuses here means gali dena. Okay. So these abuses, the physical, the domestic violence and the physical abuses were kind of a habitual thing. It's a normal thing, but that is happening in a situation where Ditu and Bunty, people like them live. The condition is so. Okay. Now let us try to get onto another slide. Okay. Now what happens? Now, Ditu, after hitting her twice, Ditu is feeling ashamed of himself. See the guilt. Why did I do this? I shouldn't have behaved like this. And he never lost his temper like this all his life. And in utter remorse. Now, he is, remorse means ye paschatap. Now, he's feeling bad about why he did this to his wife. Why did he smack her on her face? And why did he gave a blow to her? What he does is, feeling very bad about it, he gets into his bed and he puts on the blanket and covers his face and goes to sleep. And then what happened, the little boy Gullu comes to his mother and he's asking, why did Bapu beat you, Ma? Bapu is dad or father. Ma means mother. These are purely Hindi Punjabi words. Okay. Gullu asked for the third time. He asks twice. The mother didn't answer. Bunty didn't answer her son Gullu. And he's asking for the third time. Gullu is asking, Ma, why did Bapu beat you? Why did Bapu beat you? So what she tells him see that little boy, how she tries to calm that little boy. It doesn't matter, child. Husbands sometimes do beat their wives. Now the society, now we come back to the society then, which is like, you know, let me not get into the isms of feminisms and patriarchy. And so this was it, the realism, which says the society functioned like this then. Husbands sometimes do beat their wives. Panti tried to explain. That little boy, how would she explain it in terms of, would she explain it to him, all that had happened, the purse, the currency, the wallet, everything, and she had blotches because she had worn a sari and a blouse which she found as in a taichi? No, she couldn't. So what she tries to tell the little boy is, husbands sometimes do beat their wives. And what I find is, this is how orientation might be taking place. This is how sons might have been brought up then. This is what I understand, I interpret this as. Okay, so with this, we move on to the next. And you know what she does? She's not sleeping. Ditu has gone to sleep with a blanket on his face. Gullu is like sleeping with his mother besides. Okay, and she's asking Gullu, have you seen a 100 rupee note, Gullu? Have you seen a 50 rupee note, Gullu? Have you seen a 20 rupees note? Have you seen a 10 rupee note? And this is what she's asking. And Gullu says, no, ma, I haven't seen. No, ma, I haven't seen. Okay, this is happening. This happens for a long time. And, you know, at one point of time, Gullu is off to sleep. And what is Bunty doing, the mother? Bunty is still counting the currency notes. Still counting the currency notes. Okay, now let me take you all to the, let me take you all to the slide previously here. Now, what has happened? We have values, we have honesty, we have loyalty on one side, which we can attribute these qualities to Ditu. Okay, we can attribute the same qualities to Bunty as well, because you see, she is not asking for something which is not hers. What she has to say is, it is something which they had found. Okay, it's not they didn't stole it from somebody, or they didn't by force they didn't bring those wallet. It was forgotten by somebody, and that is the reason they have kept it, and they could use it for their own purpose, because it's a kind of their hard-earned money also. Okay, because the rich are careless, because the rich didn't earn money the hard way. That is what she has. Now, this mindset of Bunty for the rich people, the mindset of Ditu for the rich people, you can see. And let's not forget one thing here. He was once upon a time, when he was in Pakistan, he was from a well-to-do family. Now, see how the characters, the personality has completely changed when they become a refugee, when they are, you know, trying to survive with a meager amount that is drawn from the taxi driving. Okay, here in this short story, we also come across some superstitious beliefs. Now, if you wear somebody's sari and blouse, you don't contract leukoderma. Okay, that is what. But then Ditu believed that. And he also believed the money forgotten by the passengers, if it's something, somebody's lost property, if you found, and if you use it, it comes with a curse. That means if you use that money, something bad will happen. Okay, now here we can also find gender bias. Why this gender bias? Now see, it's not a complete, I would say, gender bias. There are some strains. Why some strains? Because see, Ditu says, I have never rudely behaved with my wife, which negates a gender bias here. Okay, again, he says, I shouldn't have behaved with her. And when he beats his wife, he is under repentance. He is like, he's under great remorse. He says, why the hell did I do that? Under what circumstances he did? He's like in a mode of remorse. I didn't want it to do it, but it happened. Okay. Now, another thing is poverty. Now, Bunty is asking that her kids should be brought up well. The boy should be into a good school, and the daughter, she wants to save money for the daughter's marriage. Now, again, something that this was prevalent in that in the society then. The moment the daughter was on, people would try to save money. For what? For so that on the during the marriage or the wedding rituals, the bride's parents had to pay dowry to the groom's parents. The dowry system was prevalent. Poverty, yes, it was very much evident. You can see the Kohli, the entire presentation of the story, which revolves around money, which revolves around situation. And at one point of time, you know what Bunty feels? She feels people say that if you eat wholesome food, now mind the word wholesome, that means under what circumstances are they surviving? The entire, you know, she feels if she eats wholesome food, her disease will slowly and steadily go away. She'll be healthy, she'll be fit, she'll be fine. The ill health is something. And another thing is domestic violence. Now, domestic violence in a case, the author here tells us that these such instances were very much usual. I mean, they were day in and day out, somebody or the other at somebody's home, somebody's Kohli, this kind of things used to happen. Physical violence, domestic violence, shouting, fighting over things. Because one thing that strikes us, the resources are meager. They had to survive with this meager income. And even with that meager income, what we find is values, the detours upholding his values, his honesty, his loyalty. He says, I don't want money. And why? Because somewhere when he was in Pakistan, he had that particular situation in his mind, and that makes him know, I don't want to use this money. So here, what the author tries to tell us is, did he compromise? Did he compromise with his values? No, he didn't compromise. But situations were held back. Okay? Situations held him back. He was not in a position to convince Bunty that we are not going to use this. And I think with this slide, the short story of the taxi driver is complete. And now I just stop sharing my slides here. I'll get back to Renuka, madam.
Yes, madam.
Yes, ma'am.
Wonderfully elaborated. I really thank you, dear, for elaborating this lesson so well and explaining the students about the details of the life of an ordinary taxi driver. His social and economic background also very nicely presented by madam through her slides. And that will really be the pictures and the descriptions that madam has given that will surely benefit our students. In addition to that, madam has dwelled on the historical and political background of the lesson, like partition and its aftermath. And madam has wonderfully conveyed the moral aspect of the lesson, like integrity, honesty, and professional ethics of an ordinary person like a taxi driver, despite all his limitations, all his problems. So I really thank you, madam, from bottom of my heart for giving such a wonderful presentation. And I hope to have such interaction in future also, such collaboration in future also with you. And I'm sure that students are greatly benefited with this lecture. Tomorrow, dear students, we are meeting with another beautiful lesson, A Cup of Tea by Catherine Mansfield. And the lesson will be explained by Dr. Leena Channani, Associate Professor and Head of Department of English, Sindhu Mahavidyalaya, Nagpur. I implore all our dear students, kindly subscribe this channel and kindly like the video and watch this video over and over again, so that it will help you for the preparation that is coming very for the examination, which is coming very soon. I wish all my dear students best wishes, best of luck for their upcoming examination and its preparation. I once again thank Dr. Veeragandham for beautifully explaining this lesson. I thank you, Dr. Professor Amit Jaiswal, sir, for being with us. And I may fail in my duty if I do not thank Dr. Karthik Panikkar, the Chairman, Board of Studies of Languages, Science and Technology, RTM Nagpur University, Nagpur, for giving this wonderful opportunity and providing this platform to the teachers, as well as helping in preparing the study material for the benefit of students. With these words, I wish to end this today's session here. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you.
Have a nice
day, madam. Have a nice day, you too. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.